Oh, here we go.
Contact.
Not very happy with getting a DNF on a race that I felt like we didn't have a chance of winning and finishing the top five. So that's really disappointing.
Oh, we got a spin.
Oh, the big one is turn one. Heavy contact. Cars in the wall.
He was doing a terrific job. Just a victim of circumstances there.
Oh, he hangs on to a contact.
He's got into Brad Keselowski.
They're mixing up down in the pits there.
He doesn't like when guys race him hard. Well, that's the sport, and that's what I do.
Coming out of turn four, first-time winner, Brad Keselowski.
Brad Keselowski has had a solid season so far, mixing it up with the Cup guys and doing just fine. And his last five races show the type of consistency that's pushed him into the top five in the standings. Plus, of course, that big breakthrough win in Nashville in early June. The driver of the Navy Chevrolet has joined us in our ESPN pit studio now. Brad, thanks for being with us. We've been talking about the first half of the season so far. How do you evaluate the first half of your season?
Well, we're right where we want to be with the U.S. Navy Chevrolet. We've been running great, got solid finishes to show. June was a great month for us, and we're looking to keep that momentum going through July.
Hey, Brad, you know, I've seen a lot of confidence on your face and in your voice since you started this season to this point. How much confidence inside has running well and working with your team and growing with that, how much more has it given you?
Well, it's all the difference in the world. You know, I know every week that I have a great team behind me with Junior Motorsports, and they're giving me great cars that can run up front. And, I know that it relies on me to get it done at the end of the day, and that's actually a good feeling. I know I can trust my team, and I'm very happy to be with Junior Motorsports.
Brad, a lot's happened to you in 12 months. Where do you see Brad Keselowski in the next 12 months?
Well, I'm going to be in the number 88 car for sure next year, and very excited about that. I'm going to be driving 88 Chevrolet and going for the championship next year, and we're going to try and get it this year and try to get it the next year. So I'm excited about that, and then we'll see about the rest.
You know, you Brad, you're every week now, you're contending or around to contend for that win. And it's like, you've taken your game up a notch. But what will it take? What does it take to win a championship in this division? I mean, obviously, you got all these Cup guys in here. What do you have to do to win a championship?
Well, right now, we're doing what we need to do. The impressive thing is Clint Bowyer. I mean, he is a rock. Never makes any mistakes, doesn't have any DNFs, and that's going to be tough to beat. We're going to need some luck to beat Clint Bowyer. And, I look back at races like Vegas that really hurt us a lot points-wise. So, you know, we need to have him have that bad luck that we had. So, I don't wish him bad luck, but we need to beat him, and we need to win more races to have a shot at him.
Put that bumper on it.
We're ready.
Don't listen to him.
The car owner hasn't come out and Brad yet, no.
All right. When you started this job, everybody knew you as Brad Keselowski driving for Dale Jr., and that's all they want to talk about. All right. Is he a tough boss?
He can be. You know, there's highlights and there's lowlights. Running here with him and having a teammate like Dale Jr., to run at Daytona and Talladega is as good as it gets. Having the competitors that are competing in that five car as a teammate has strengthened my program, so I'm thankful to have them. But it's tough. There's a lot of pressure that comes with driving for Dale Jr., but I'm lucky to be in those shoes.
You start second tonight. You're fast for two laps. Didn't get a lot of practice yesterday. Only one of the two practices. The other one was rained out. Did you get to make a long run at all? How's your car for the race?
We made about 3 10-lap runs, and we were extremely loose. So I'm hoping that the car will come around. We've built our car more for speed than handling, I believe, and we'll see how that plays out. I'm hoping that as it gets cooler, that speed will be what you need. So we'll find out.
I know you've been asked this 100 times off the air. Pronounce your name for everybody in the world.
It's Keselowski.
See, now, just making sure, because, you know, a lot of people, when your dad raced for so many years, a lot of people just called him Keselowski, and it's kind of all mixed up, and we just wanted to set the record straight.
Yeah, I'll settle with anything that starts with a K and ends with an I.
There you go. All right, Brad, start second tonight. Good luck. Maybe tonight's a night for a big Daytona win.
We're excited about it. Great race tonight, July 4th, celebrating Independence Day, driving the Navy Chevrolet, and happy to be doing it.
That's a pretty big deal. Thanks for taking the time to be with us.
Thanks.
Brad Keselowski joining us. He starts on the outside of the front row tonight.